que tu fais?
Bah, je te donne un coup de pompe.
On fait pas ça à Chloé Dubreuc, ok?
Mais Chloé, qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Non! I'm sorry, but I didn't choose this expression in the right sense of it. It was just an excuse to put flour on Elise. In fact, in French we say rouler quelqu'un dans la farine. But if we translate word by word in English, that doesn't mean anything. We get to roll someone in flour, and it's a bit stupid. So let's see what this expression means. In French, it means to swindle someone, or when you lie to someone, or more when you trick someone. This expression comes from the 19th century, and it comes from roll in the sense of mislead, like I was fooled. And flower comes from the flower which was used for the makeup of the character in the past. They put flower on their face to be unrecognizable and to be able to fool people. So the English expression that corresponds to mine, rouler quelqu'un dans la farine, is to con someone or to take somebody for a ride. Ouh, j'ai un coup de pompe!
Avoir un coup de pompe is a French expression. If we translate this expression word by word, we get to have a pump blow, which is completely stupid. So let's see what this expression means. Avoir un coup de pompe means to become suddenly tired and sometimes with no reasons. It comes from the 20th century. During a flight by plane, there were a lot of turbulences, and during these turbulences, the plane was shaking because of the air columns. The pilot compared these air columns to a pump. And he called a turbulence un coup de pompe, a pump blow. We say avoir un coup de pompe because after the flight and after all the turbulences, the passengers were very tired. Now I will give you the English expression that corresponds to mine. In English, you say to be faked out.
Tu ne devineras jamais ce que j'ai vu hier à la télé.
Non, quoi?
Ben vas-y, devine.
Je sais pas, j'ai pas regardé la télé hier, mais ma mère m'a parlé d'un crash de montgolfière.
Ah non, c'est pas ça du tout, ça c'était en Colombie, alors que mon histoire c'était en Australie.
Et il s'est passé quoi?
Ça s'est passé dans une bijouterie à Sydney.
Quelqu'un a acheté la bague la plus chère du monde?
Non, rien à voir. Qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Bah, je donne ma langue au chat.
Ah, en fait, je t'explique. Un voleur est allé dans une bijouterie, et lorsqu'il a voulu soutirer l'argent de la caisse, le bijoutier lui a pointé son arme et celui-ci a pris ses jambes à son cou.
In French we say donner sa langue au chat, but if we translate this expression word by word, we get to give his tongue to the cat, but it's completely stupid. So let's see what this expression means. This expression comes from 19th century. Is give up giving a solution. When we don't say the solution, we use this expression. And the English expression that corresponds to mine, donner sa langue au chat, is to give in.
So in French, we say prendre ses jambes à son cou. If we translate word by word, we get to take to his legs to his neck. Let's see what this expression means. Originally, we say prendre ses jambes à son cou, and it comes from 18th century. That means to go on a trip. yes, you must. You have to use your legs to move, and the bag was tied to the neck. And the bag was tied to the neck, so in the collar. In the 19th century, the sense changed to show the speed, and if we translate the originally expression is to take to one's heels.
Hé, Ophélie, tu ne devineras jamais. J'ai vu un stylo d'une demi-tonne dans le journal de mon voisin.
Mais non, c'est pas possible.
Ah si, si, je te jure.
Mais non, c'est pas possible, je te dis que c'est pas possible.
J'en mettrai ma main au feu.
Mais non.
Si.
Mais enfin, Pauline, tu es bête à manger du foin. So, my expression is bête à manger du foin. If we translate word by word, it's used to... if you translate word by word, we get you are too stupid as to eat A, which is completely stupid. My expression is used to say that someone is stupid, but here it wasn't on the right context. My expression dates back off to the 18th century. The word beast in English is used to speak about animal. We say that someone is stupid and we compare it with an animal. And the word foin, A in English, is used to speak about food of animals like sheep and horses. So if we and for say that for speak about something with little value of without interest. So if we make connection between these two words, it's not really a compliment. We say that the person is stupid, and in addition to the point of it something without interest. The expressions that correspond to mine in English is as smart as a gnat or dumb as a rock. Do you know this expression? Do you use them?
My expression is I will stake my life on it. This expression comes from the Middle Ages. When somebody was accused of a crime without proof, he crossed the test. The name's test is le jugement de Dieu. An example of a test is put the hen in the fire, and then if it takes out unhurt in less of 3 days, the person was innocent. But now we know if someone says this expression, he will not will put his hen in the fire.
Mais qu'est-ce qu'il y a, Cyril? Qu'est-ce qui se passe?
Je viens de me prendre un râteau. La fille que je devais voir aujourd'hui n'est pas venue.
Ah, mais t'inquiète, un jour l'amour arrivera d'elle, de vous-même.
Oui, peut-être, tu as peut-être raison. Oh, mais j'ai une idée. Ça dirait venir au cinéma avec moi?
Je vais regarder si j'ai le temps.
Alors?
Ben, j'ai du temps pour toi.
Quand?
Quand les poules auront des dents. So, in French, we say, quand les poules auront des dents. If we translate this expression word by word, we use when the chicken will have teeth, which is completely stupid because there aren't any teeth. Let's see what this expression means. You can use it to tell someone that will never happen. So we use it to say never. This expression appeared at the end of the 18th century. There are also other expressions to say the same thing, like the week of the fourth Thursday. And at the end of the 19th century, they used when the chicken will piss. It's the same tradition. So my expression, quand les poules auront des dents, in English, it's when the pigs fly. It's very different, even if it's talk about animals too.
De toute façon, j'ai jamais aimé elle. En plus, elle est vraiment pas belle. J'aime vraiment pas, donc ça sert à rien que j'aille avec elle. So, my expression is casser du sucre sur le dos de quelqu'un. That is an expression. Don't worry. We don't waste the sugar. It's just an expression. It's strange, is it not? So, if we translate this expression word by word, we get break some sugar on someone's back, which is completely stupid. Let's see the meaning of this expression. The meaning of this expression is when you speak badly about someone when he isn't there. In the past, this expression is no, sorry. In the past, the piece of sugar was as big as a bread, not small and square like today. And if you wanted a piece of sugar, you had to break it, the piece of sugar, and in the 18th century, if you say casser du sucre sur quelqu'un, it's you say prendre pour un imbécile. If I translate, it's prendre pour un imbécile is means say someone is an idiot or a stupid guy. After that, in the second half of the 19th century, it's on his back has added of this expression casser du sucre, and in this this century we have added on his back after that. For the gangsters, casser le morceau, break the piece, means denounce your partner of crime. And in English, in the English expression is to gossip or to talk about someone on his back.